Hello and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. Okay, so today is the 15th of May and I am preparing for the launch of my new reinvent of the shop. And for that, I am doing a vast range of different versions of different designs in lots of different fabrics and lots of different styles, hopefully. So this is one of the styles that I have partly stitched. As I'm going along, I want to keep on explaining, because I think what's going to happen is I'm going to become overwhelmed, and it's going to, later on, it's going to become a little bit too difficult. Now, these are actually partly stitched, and I want to give the explanations as I'm going along. So the cut of this dress is basically the same as the anarkalis that we've been doing. There are in total 8 panels in this one, so it's 16 panels. I did run a little bit. I was using this net. This dress is based on net, and I was actually using this on sleeves for the other variations. And basically what happened was, along the way I had this massive craving, why don't I do one out of this as well? So when I came to actually doing this outfit, I cut the panels very in narrow, and this was due to the fact that one of the previous one I'd done was a lot wider, and it came out too wide in the waist, and I had to slim it down. And for some reason, you know, the shape doesn't always look right when they're just a little bit wider. So when I thinned this down, it actually came out just a little bit too tight. It was the size, it was probably a size maybe an 8 or a 10. Length was quite long, but there was a problem that it wasn't coming out wide enough on the upper portion. Now, there's two things that I did with that. One, I obviously added the pieces to go into the sides, and secondly, the kallis were same from the top as they were on the waist, and obviously on the shoulders you need it slightly wider. Also, I needed the piece for the cut. So because I wasn't getting this piece out and I still wanted the waist fitting, what I did was I inserted an inch kallis every second piece along here up to the waistline to widen the upper portion of the chest area. So what you've got basically is 16 down where the waistline is. I've inserted an 14 15 inch piece, and you know, cut at an angle, so it's like a narrow V going all the way down. And there are 5 of these pieces attached between the kallis. So I opened the kallis up to that area and then attached those pieces, and what that basically has done is it's given me the waist, but then it's widened it up from that area. And because they're panels and they're on net, you can't actually tell the difference at all. That's really the close-up of the dress. Then I went along, and obviously I was running short on, because I'd used all the fabric on the previous cut and I wanted to give a little bit of a different variation on this. I did the sleeves in the red net because I was using red as the comparison with this. Now, the whole trigger of this outfit was a piece of this lace. And this lace was probably maybe a length of 2 yards, and I just didn't want to, you know, use it on just anything. So that 2 yards of lace, a piece of red fabric, actually did the whole of the outfit. It looks amazing. I tell you, it's phenomenal. I did, you know, the contrast, the colors, they're so vibrant and so bright and so summery that, you know, it's a proper eye catcher, of a dress. So what you have is approximately 4 yards of lace on the hem. Then you have a yard of fabric that's been cut into the strips and used as all the binding. Then you've got half a yard of the fabric red, which I've used and cut and piped with. The lace is just used on the front, and it actually breaks off here, so the back of this is just red and green. In the past, I've been doing the lace all the way around, but on this particular one, because I ran out, I've used it just on the front, and it looks equally well. The front, I left that open, and then I've done the piping. So I've attached two pipings, attached this on the wrong side, turned it towards the right side, and stitched over on both the sides. And then I've attached this to the lining. So I've done a top seam, center marked the lining piece, which is in silk in the slightly lighter color, and I center marked that, and then basically just put this on top and just, you know, seamed over it so that although it's closed, it still looks like an open shirt. And I will be using the heavy red buttons to button this off, so you will see a modeling of this outfit. But prior to that, I wanted to give an explanation that if you want to make anything like this, the fabric used in this is 2.5 yards of net, a yard of the red fabric for the sleeves, 2.5 yards for the lining, and 2.5 yards for the churidar. So if you wanted to make something like this, follow the tutorial in the similar manner to any of the anargalis. But if you're going out shopping for the fabrics, then you need 2.5 yards of the net. You need, and this net is 58 inches wide. You need a yard, probably a yard of the red fabric, because we are going to pipe the dupatta in this as well. A yard of the green fabric, 2.5 yards for churidar, and 2.5 yards for the salwar lining. And you need, preferably, you need this lace 4 yards and this lace 4 yards, four and a half, just to be safe. Perhaps this one 4.5 or 5 yards, because if you're going to use it on the sleeves as well, then, you know, obviously you need it for that as well. So that basically is outfit number one. It's still a slight bit of just a square, slightly angled out square neckline, and that needs to be just turned over. The back still needs to be finished, and the hem still needs to be done on this. But really, that is one of the outrageous and wow anargalis that to go with my wow fashion extravaganza, inshallah, on the 1st of June.